Hello, welcome to Communication Skills for Everyone. Today, let's learn Kurt Sellers summary. This is written by Masthi Venkatesa Iyengar. So, Masthi Venkatesa Iyengar was a well-known writer in Kannada language. He was the fourth among Kannada writers to be honored with the Gyanpith Award, which is the highest literary honor conferred in India. The Kurt Seller by Masthi Venkatesa Iyengar effectively displayed the politics of everyday life in most simple houses and a struggle for power. So the short story, The Kurt Seller, is all about a middle-aged, uneducated, naive woman who makes a living by selling curds, a commodity like curds, as a limited self-life. The culture of making curd, the storage, preparation, and distribution requires a special skill. This story takes place in the outskirts of Bengaluru. There are homes which buy curds from the pot that the curd seller brings. The texture and the quality of the product and its regular delivery ensure regular business and loyal customers. The problems faced by weather in transporting and delivering the product afresh can only be managed by a smart, efficient seller like Mangamma. Buying and selling in small town villages purely depend on relationships that thrive on trust. Mangamma's interaction is limited to the lady of the house, who also develops a bond because of their everyday interaction. It is common to discuss the little joys and challenges of their respective homes if time, weather, occasions are conducive for an informal short sessions. Amidst conversation, Mangamma's advice to the lady of the house blurs the invisible social barrier that exists between the two classes. A naive Mangamma gives tips to the lady of the house on safeguarding her marriage by exercising control over the husband. According to her, an attractive appearance and a little saving for the rainy day are the secret ingredients to a successful marriage. Her worldly knowledge amuses the lady of the house and she becomes her close friend. Mangamma's identity is defined by the curd seller and the social relations she maintains with the people whom she interacts on an everyday basis. Mangamma and her daughter-in-law have a row over disciplining the little grandson in the family. One argument leads to another and Mangamma is forced to live alone. The independent, empowered Mangamma is distraught with a sudden twist of events in the predictable routine. On second thoughts, a rational Mangamma decides to love herself and spend on her clothes to dress modestly, as she does not feel the need to save anymore. She decides to splurge a little and pamper herself. She even confronts a city boy who marks her fondness for expensive clothes as she wears one of those mukmul blouses. She has a mind of her own and she confidently defies convention to wear nice expensive clothes and be presentable and give herself the comfort of soft linen. An educated single woman in a village separated from her husband and doesn't think twice to assert herself. She even confronts her son and daughter-in-law on her choice of fabric and doesn't feel threatened by their comments. The social construction doesn't allow the women to handle her finances without the support of a male member in the family. This is evident when a confident, worldly wise Mangamma is intimidated by the advances of Rangappa. After she is separated from her son, she realizes the need to secure the earrings with her trusted confidant, right, friend, the lady of the house. The lady from the higher social order comes across as a timid woman who cannot take a stand to help out Mangamma by keeping her earrings with her. She gives an evasive reply and says she needs her husband's permission. She comes across as less empowered woman who is economically comfortable but chooses to be the subservient gender by using her husband, the powerful and decision-making individual of the house, as an alibi for her convenience. She is identified as a powerless lady of the house who is unwilling to help her rise up to the occasion. The empowered, financially independent, yet a very emotional Mangamma is reluctant to break ties with the loving son, daughter-in-law and grandson. She is shocked with Rangappa's advances towards her when she starts living independently. She realizes the physical strength of her male counterpart is certainly overpowering. She is smart enough to make peace, but her ego will not let her make the first move. The struggle of power by the two women in the family is evident. They are all out to prove their grit and determination. So Mangamma's equally sensible, smart daughter-in-law, Nanjamma, hatches a plan to take control of the situation by instructing her young son to be around Mangamma. Mangamma is proud that the grandson has chosen to live with her and decides to soften her stand and for her son and daughter-in-law. Mangamma welcomes the grandson, who she thinks is a good substitute for the absence of any male member in her life. The established tradition in the society invariably trusts the idea of a male being a sense of security and power of the women, irrespective age and physical strength. The reconciliation happens in a subtle way, with the control of finances and domestic chores being shared by the two women. Mangamma exchanges her profitable curd selling businesses for the control that she can establish in the management at home and live a secure life with love and respect. A happy Ninjamma takes over the established profitable business and makes peace with Mangamma. The struggle for power is evident in every society, irrespective of the social order they represent. This is the story by the curd seller by Masti Venkatesha Iyengar. Thank you for watching. Subscribe Communication Skills for Everyone for more academic and educational videos.